Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the problem where you can't change the fill color of something, it only changes the outline color, if that makes sense. We'll go over a couple different ways to fix this. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I have some simple outline designs from Vecteezy.com. I'm going to select everything and then come up here to color. Sometimes it'll come in all black like this. I'll just change this to RGB. So just click the flyout and change it to RGB. Then you can double click and choose a different color. And as you can see, these objects are a fill only, even though they look like outlines, they don't have strokes. So this means that the stroke was probably expanded or this was made with some kind of brush or something like that. I'm going to go ahead and change these to a darker green color, something right around here. And now I want to get the fills of these to be a different color. So there are a few ways to do that. First, I'm going to hit K to get to the Live Paint Bucket tool. We can choose a color and then just click this part to fill it. You can see above the paint bucket that we have three colors. You can use your arrow keys to move through the colors in your swatches easily instead of coming all the way over here to your swatches to click on those. So I'm going to change this one to blue. And we'll make this yellow. So the paint bucket tool works really well if you have a simple shape like this. You can see that the bounding box looks a little different. So this is a paint bucket group and we need to expand this. So I'm just going to come up to object and expand. We'll say okay. Now the only thing about the paint bucket tool is that you have to click on each section individually to fill it. So if you have something really detailed like these plant shapes over here, you can just do it all at once by drawing a rectangle behind it that's whatever color that you want. So we'll hit M to get to our rectangle tool, which is right over here. I'm going to click the green color. I'm going to draw a rectangle that'll cover all of the plant shapes. And then we'll send this to the back with Shift Command left bracket, that's Shift Control left bracket on a PC. Then I'll use my group selection to just select the plants and that box. And we'll come down here to Pathfinder and divide. Now what this is doing is actually breaking apart all of these and making shapes out of them. So with my group selection tool, if I click on this background shape and move it, you can see that the green pieces have been cut out of this background shape. So I'm just going to delete that background shape. Now if we zoom in, every single piece is colored with green, which is what I want. But the thing is, it won't get your negative shapes, so you have to click on those individually and delete those. Now if I want to recolor some of these flowers, I can do that easily by just clicking on the dark green part of the flower and hiding it with Command 3. And then I'll just select those little pieces up there, we'll change those to pink, and then I'll unhide with Option Command 3 or Alt Control 3 on a PC. We'll do the same over here. I'll click on the dark pieces and I'll hide those with Command 3. By the way, I'm using my group selection tool to do this. Then I'll select just those pieces up there. And this time I'm going to use a magenta, but I want to make it a lot lighter. We'll say okay. And I'll unhide with Option Command 3, Alt Control 3 on a PC. I'll do the same here. And we'll make this yellow. And maybe this one can be an orange color. So that's how to quickly add color if you're working with outlines only that have actually been expanded into fills. All right, I hope this video has helped you with this problem. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.